If you've got an older Apple Mac computer that you installed macOS Sierra on with DOS 2.1's patch tool, there's some important news for you. You knew there was a step where you have to patch your system, and one of the patches made it be able to receive software updates. If you did it around February 2017 or later, there was a software update patch integrated into the tool, and in that case you should be fine. But if you don't see new updates like macOS 10.12.6 from July 2017, or if you use the older method, which was the AUS Enabler app, you might be having a problem in that you can no longer find updates. First of all, simply open the App Store on your unsupported Mac running Sierra and just check for updates. Press Command and R at this screen if it doesn't begin checking. If it finds 10.12.6, you're good to go. Otherwise, you need to apply this new patch as explained on DOS Dude 1's website. At first, I didn't even notice it because it was all the way at the bottom of the page. But what you do is go to it and download this script. After downloading, you extract it and then you open the terminal app. Inside the terminal app, type in sudo space software update one word space dash dash clear dash catalog and press enter. If it asks for your password, type it in and press enter. I've already done it before, so I won't do it again. When typing your password, you won't see it, not even dots. When that's done, use the terminal to navigate to where the extracted software update patch is. If you don't know, it's likely in your downloads folder, so just type in CD space downloads with the capital D and then press enter. Now type in sudo space dot slash swu patch dot sh and press enter. It will download some stuff and copy it to your system folder. Don't worry, it's safe. When it's done, it offers you to check for updates right now. Press Y if you want to do it now, otherwise type anything else, then press Enter. And now you can close the terminal, open the App Store, and install all the updates you want. You can also install them with the command line using the software update command. If you want to learn how to do that, see the guide linked in the description. Thank you for watching, and happy staying safe online with the latest software updates.